silence while we stand aside and look. Ooh, some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption.
Japan finally recognized the Ainu as indigenous. This is probably as a result of international pressure and the promise of tourism. There is much research on the Ainu in Hokkaido, but most don't know that the Ainu inhabited the islands, all the islands in the area. They were even found in mainland Asia. Anthropologists said that they found some people in Korea that looked similar to Native Americans. In Nihon Shiku, Takahashi wrote that in the eastern wilds, there is a country called Hitakimi. The men and the women tie their hair in a form of a mullet. They also tattoo their bodies. They have a fierce temper, and their name is Yamishi. This is added that the land is wide and fertile, and that the emperor should attack these people immediately. The Ainu were called both Izo and Imishi. Izo is a corruption of the Ainu word Ijimi. The two groups that made up the Imishi were the native Ainu and the Japanese that were adopted by the Ainu. The Japanese fought to a standstill with the Ainu. Both sides agreed to a treaty. The Imishi, bound by honor, met with the Japanese unarmed and ready for peace. The Japanese broke their word and took the chiefs captive. The chiefs of the Seminoles were told that they would be reconnected with their families. The Americans took the Seminole chiefs captive. The Seminole chiefs later made a daring escape. The Imishis were beheaded. Among those beheaded was the great chief Ateru. Ateru was the chief of the Isawa Imishi. Ateru defeated the Shogun's warriors numerous times. Ateru's small force of 500 horse archers easily defeated Yamato's heavy foot soldiers, numbering about 50,000 strong. The Imishi horse archers easily outmaneuvered the foot soldiers. The Imishi archers were without equal, and when met face to face, the Imishi were brave and valiant and skillful swordsmen. Ateru and his tribe fought bravely. The Japanese used China as an example. When the Chinese were faced with a small, highly skilled team of Xiongnu warriors, they succeeded in attracting other tribes to fight and killed their chiefs after a long drinking party. This mirrors what happened in Japan. The first shogun, who was said to be a descendant from the Han Chinese, came along. This is where he got respected. Ateru was highly respected by both friend and foe. He became a hero, praised for his resourcefulness and also his bravery. He is a prime example of the kind of leadership that we all need today.
This relationship appears to be driven by longer radii antigone relative to humeri and femora among Jomon compared to Yayoi people, or alternatively, shortened tibiae and radii relative to femora and humeri among Yayoi compared to Jomon people. This finding supports the first hypothesis of the study by illustrating significant differences in relative limb length between Jomon and Yayoi people. In addition, the second hypothesis that predicts greater distal relative to proximal limb lengths among Jomon compared to Yayoi people and reduced distal relative to proximal limb length among Yayoi compared to Jomon people is also supported. Two important similarities are revealed by the cluster analysis of size standardized limb lengths. First, Jomon limb shape is similar to groups from tropical environment at lower latitudes. These groups include samples from Africa, Australia, Florida, the Philippines, and Thailand.